morning, mommy.
But I know Jesus.
Hey, it's Mommy Monday. Let's talk about those mommy duties.
I walk on water, but only when it freezes.
Why are expectations so high?
Good morning, all my beautiful, amazing moms. So it's Mommy Monday, and I want to talk to you guys about a few mommy things. Number one, being a mom does not mean that you have to let yourself go. Actually, it means the exact opposite. It means that more so now than ever, you have to take better care of yourself because you're responsible for other people besides yourself. When you were younger, if you went out and got drunk and like overslept or was hungover the next morning, it didn't affect anybody else. But if you do that now, there's a little person who looks up to you and they're watching. When you were younger, if you got stressed out, you know, it was okay, you dealt with it. But now if you get stressed out, it might cause you to lash out at, again, a little person who looks up to you. What we as moms fail to realize sometimes is whatever our stress and issues are, that little person has nothing to do with it. We're responsible for that person. We chose to bring them into this world, and it's our responsibility to shield them from even our own bad things in life. If I had a bad day at work, it's not my child's fault. I can't come home and be short-tempered because of that child. So I have to develop ways to de-escalate my situation prior to interacting with my children. If I'm stressed out about money, I can't look at my kid and say, "You're always freaking begging. Don't ask me for anything." It's not fair. It's their job as our children to ask us for things. So we have to make a way to provide or find a kind way to let them know that we can. So what I used to say to my kids all the time is, "Not today, maybe next time," if I couldn't afford to buy them things. Mark had gotten to the point, because you know, Mark was my single mother child. I raised him predominantly by myself, and until I got with Dee, and then we eventually got married. And Mark started asking me for things in this fashion: "Mom, can I have this today?" Because he knew that my answer sometimes was not today. So it was never like, "No, like, leave me alone." It was always like, "Not today, baby, maybe next time." And he had gotten used to that, and he understood that. I never said to him, "Mommy doesn't have any money. Don't ask me for anything." That kid doesn't need to know that. Your child should never know that they've stressed you out to that extent, or that you know, they're begging. Or listen, it's not their deal, it's your deal. It's not that they're asking for too much, it's that you haven't gone out and made enough. So let that motivate you. Go out and make more money so that you don't have to do that to your children. Okay, so that's that part. Now back up again to these kids and our mommy duties. Our kids are gonna learn who they are from us. So if you continuously tell your child, "You're annoying, you're a pain in the butt, you're dumb," any of these things, that's who that child becomes. If you tell your child, "Oh my gosh, you're so smart, you're beautiful, you're so talented, you're so funny," that is who that child becomes. And more so than that, they become a person with confidence. Now, I know we all know somebody with confidence and self-esteem issues. Do you want to create another person like that? No, so don't give your child those hangups. Tell your child they're amazing, they're smart, they can do anything. You know, these are the things that change the world. As moms, we have the capacity to change the world because we give our children who they're gonna become. Even amazing people with amazing talents will look and say they can't do it if they've been told enough by their parents in childhood. So tell your children all the great things about them, and then help them work on the things that they're not great at. If they make a mistake, correct them with love, not with criticism and hate in your voice. Let them know that you're correcting them because you love them. I can't tell you how many times I've told my babies, if I didn't care, I wouldn't fix it. And they understand that. And now they treat each other in that way. They'll tell each other, hey, don't do that. If I didn't care, I wouldn't tell you not to do that. They help each other to not break the rules, to stay on track, to stay successful in school. I'll never forget, Dash had a rough fourth grade. Like, I don't know what was going on with him, if it was just an age difference or he was changing or what, but the entire summer between fourth and fifth grade, they just spent that entire summer teaching Dash everything she could possibly teach him. She did summer school with him every day because, you know, she was in sixth grade going to seventh, and she was in all AP classes, extremely intelligent. So she spent every day teaching him things to help him be more successful in fifth grade. And now he is in fifth grade, and all I get from his teacher is emails about how wonderful it is to have him in the class and how intelligent he is, how much he participates. And I owe that completely to Daisha and how much she loved and cared for him to the point that she spent her summer helping him be better. So in being a strong, positive, helpful, loving mom, I created a strong, positive, helpful, loving young lady who, even though she acts like she hates her brother and they fight a lot and things like that, when he needed her, she jumped right in and was there for him. That's what we want to create in our children. We want to create children who are filled with love and the desire to help other people, starting at home. Because if we don't do that for one another, we'll never help other people outside of the home. If we're not loving and caring to the people that we interact with every day, do you think we'll be loving and caring with strangers? We won't. So, back to the beginning, ladies, let's keep our problems contained, work on them with ourselves, our loved ones, our mentors, our friends, not with our children. It's not their place. Children deserve a chance to just be happy. Find kind ways to say no to your children. Find encouraging ways to correct your children. Because this is the future. And do you want to be an elderly woman with a child who's mean and says hateful things to you? No, you want to be an elderly woman with a child who's loving and remembers all the love and care you gave at one point and is giving it back to you. You want to be a grandma with grandchildren who come over and are kind and confident because you gave your child that and they then gave it to their children. So let's make the world a better place, starting at home with our children. Peace out, y'all. Happy Mommy Monday. Go home and tell your kids something positive. Give them lots of hugs and kisses.